And Cavite 4th District Representative Elpidio Barzaga now joins us on the program for more on Tuesday's House hearing into the high prices of onions. Congressman, good afternoon to you, and thank you for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Carmina.
All right, so let's start off our discussion with Lea Cruz, with what she said during the first and the second hearing. What is clear to you now about who she is and the role that she plays?
Well, as early as 2014, I have filed a House resolution calling an investigation insofar as importation of garlic and onions are concerned. And in that investigation, I have read from the newspapers and even from the reports of the volunteers, BACC, that a certain Lea Cruz is manipulating or controlling the importation of onions and garlic. And so the House conducted an investigation. I was able to confront Lea Cruz. And of course, there was always a denial. But in the last hearing, she admitted that on the basis of our investigation in Congress in 2014, a criminal case was filed against her before the ombudsman.
But then, now that you're hearing her name again and that you're seeing her for a second time, based on still the same allegations, what does that tell you, Congressman?
Well, it seems that notwithstanding our investigation, Lea Cruz is controlling still the importation and perhaps the hoarding and price manipulation of onions. As a matter of fact, no less than the chairman of Bonena Cooperative, in the person of Israel Reguyal, has stated openly during our public hearing yesterday that Lea Cruz is still there. And so I was really disappointed because this problem cropped up way back in 2014. Now it has been 8 years have gone. Still we are facing the same problem. And the irony of it, even Director Panganiban of the Bureau of Land and Industry has stated also in our public hearing that this problem has been in occurrence for the last 50 years. And so I asked him, does it mean that the government agencies cannot do anything to solve all these problems pertaining to hoarding and smuggling and price manipulation of onion, which actually affects the life of every Filipino?
And the answer to that, is government totally inept? Yeah.
Well, the answer given by Director Panganiban is that they have already a plan. Unfortunately, the plan has not been put into action. So what we did was to request a copy of that plan. And moreover, when I started questioning or clarifying the government agencies who have the legal obligation to conduct an investigation, up to the present, no data has been presented to us officially. According to the National Bureau of Investigation, they are still collecting the data, the intelligence information, and unfortunately, up to the present, they have not identified or they have not invited any person for questioning insofar as this issue is concerned. Insofar as the Bureau of Customs is concerned, they also gave the official report, unfortunately, due to lack of time, we were not able to verify the status of this report, although they stated that they have been some cases pending before the Department of Justice. Unfortunately, the report given to us does not specify what cases involve onions. It is generic by a misdeclaration of agricultural products. Insofar as negative question, they have also the same information given to us. They are still collecting all the available data, and that is also the position of the Philippine Competitive Commission. So we are all a little bit disappointed.
Well, Congressman, sorry to cut you there, Congressman. Yes. Congressman, it's been 8 years. You've stated that since the start of this conversation. So what do you believe at this point? is it really just a lack of action that they're in the middle of the whole process, or are they in on it as well?
Well, as a lawyer, my personal opinion is there is a collusion. Leia Cruz cannot manipulate all this holding price manipulation by herself alone. There must be collusion with some persons connected with the government and perhaps possibly with the Bureau of Plant Industry and the Bureau of Customs.
And so with the executive session that, I'm sorry to cut you there, but with the executive session that happened yesterday, what did you glean from that executive session without revealing too much to us, Congressman?
Well, I was a little bit disappointed. Not a little bit. Because as a lawyer, I did not get enough information which I think should be given in an executive session. No personalities were identified. The evidence was submitted in spite of the fact that it was an executive session.
Hmm. Why is that so? Why did that happen?
Well, because before we conducted the executive session, Rabuyal and requested for an executive session. And unfortunately, we were not able to verify what information he would be giving. And the same is with Leia Cruz. She was also subjected to executive session after we have an executive session with Rabuyal, and practically the statement given by Leia Cruz is what he's been stating openly and publicly.
So this is not your first rodeo, Congressman Barsaga. You know what's happening. Tell us why. Tell us why the executive session did not yield the results that you were expecting.
Well, as we have seen, there was a statement coming from Leia Cruz during the public hearing that she is invoking the right invoking her constitutional right to be silent insofar as the questions being propounded on her are concerned. And practically, although she did not invoke that in the executive session, no material or vital information has been given. Mm-hmm. No names were given, no corporations were given who are involved in price manipulation as well as hoarding.
And why was that so? Was there someone protecting her or discouraging her from giving those vital pieces of information, Congressman?
Well, my perception is that if she would be stating all this vital information, that will be prejudicial to herself. And therefore, she does not want to give any information which later on can be used against her.
So why?
Because in that particular case, there will be a waiver of her constitutional right against self-incrimination. Mm-hmm.
So why have the executive session to begin with?
Well, that Rabuyal was the one who invoked it, mm-hmm. as well as Leia Cruz, mm-hmm. and believing in good faith, all the members of Congress present, we would be able to receive vital information in the executive session. Mm. Unfortunately, my own perception and my own opinion, we did not receive such vital information, which I expect.
Were you taken for a ride, Congressman?
Session.
Congressman, were you taken for a ride? Because you said you believed in good faith. Go ahead.
Yes. Well, they are very intelligent people. You cannot manipulate the prices. You cannot control the price of onion. You cannot be the head of the cartel unless you are intelligent and you can manipulate people. And that is the reason why we have to conduct further investigation.
Are you saying, Congressman, that this Leia Cruz is in the process of manipulating your esteemed colleagues, including yourself?
were satisfied based on her answers. There is manipulation. Nasa wikang Tagalog, pinaikot lamang kami. And that has been always shared testimony. Hindi ko maalala, I cannot recall. I will be telling all their names in the next scheduled hearing. I am being attacked only in the press, but I don't know who are the persons attacking me. Things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Her answers are always evasive to the questions which we are propounding. Mm-hmm. And therefore, we have to seek the truth from other persons other than Lea Cruz.
And speaking of other persons other than Lea Cruz, she's not the only one that you're investigating, am I correct?
Yes, of course. Oh. Israel Reguyal was present in yesterday's hearing.
Mm.
And he is also the chairman of the Bonema Cooperative.
Mm.
And he even stated before us that Lea Cruz was the one who is controlling the prices of onions.
But she wasn't the only one because on that list that was bared during the first hearing. Are you also going after all these persons as well on that list?
Well, we have so many persons who will be invited in the next hearing. And all these persons are involved in so far as importation of onions is concerned.
Can you give us a rundown of those names, Congressman?
Well, as of now, I don't have the records. I could not recall all of them. But definitely, we will be inviting all of them. Invitations has been already sent by the COMSEC, and we shall schedule the hearing.
Can you recall maybe 2-3 names?
Well, there are certain two Chinese importers. I don't exactly remember. They are claiming that they are the so-called Big Five or the one controlling onions insofar as Luzon is concerned.
Mm.
And we don't have the specifics right now.
Do you recall of a certain Michael Ma was also included in that list and if he has been invited as well by the committee?
Well, I don't recall any name Michael Ma. What I recall is that there is a certain Michael Yang. Unfortunately, we don't have the exact address. And you know for a fact that insofar as Chinese is concerned, most of them have similar names.
Mm.
So we will pursue that issue, Angel.
In the first...
Regarding that, yes.
Yeah, sorry to cut you there, Congressman, but in the first hearing, there were names bared. There's Michael Ma, Lu Jin Ang, Andrew Chang, Beverly Perez, a certain Aaron, Manuel Tan, of course, Lea Cruz. There's June Diamante, Lucia Lim, and Jerry Tevez. Any of those names familiar to you, Congressman?
None is familiar to me. As a matter of fact, I have to tell you honestly that all these persons were not yet invited for the second hearing.
Oh.
They were not present yesterday.
Yeah. But for the third hearing, have they been invited?
Well, we don't have yet the complete list of those persons to be invited. You know, we have also to consider the time limitation. Yesterday, we have a number of resource persons. Some of them were not able to speak because of the executive session which we conducted, which lasted for almost 3 to 4 hours.
Mm.
And they were waiting only in the other room, in the second floor. The other resource persons, including the media, including the other guests.
Mm. Well, we've heard from the House Speaker himself saying that you guys will go after everyone who has been involved in the price manipulation, smuggling, hoarding of all these important agricultural products. He even said, moderate your greed. Have we come to that, Congressman Barsaga, just a moderation of greed? What do you want to come out of these hearings?
Well, number one, I want to find out the evidence to warrant the filing of appropriate cases against those persons who are really involved in so far as hoarding and manipulation is concerned. Number two, I would like also to have some remedial legislation, whether or not, how do we determine the so-called certificate of necessity to import, which unilaterally is being determined by the Bureau of Plant and Industry after having a meeting with the so-called stakeholders. Insofar as I'm concerned, if there are issues like this, and if there will be meetings, I think it is necessary that the media should be present so that they can witness the proceedings in order that everybody could know what really is the problem. Because the way I look at it, the information regarding the onions to be imported basically comes from the stakeholders, and this means the farmers. However, insofar as the farmers are concerned, we have the so-called stock brokers. All the harvest of the farmers are being bought by the stock by the onion stockers, and they place that in a cold storage and later on sold it to the public market when the prices are already high. So this is actually what is happening. And what is happening is the basic application of the law on supply and demand. The more demand there is and the lesser supply, of course the price would be higher. Unfortunately, there is actually supply, but the supply of onions are being not placed to the market, but being actually stored in the cold storage. And this is also one thing which we have to investigate.
Finally, Congressman, of course, we're talking about Lea Cruz now, but do you believe that more names will be mentioned?
Well, insofar as Lea Cruz is concerned, I do not think that she would be mentioning additional names. And therefore, we have to resort on other methods of investigating and finding the truth.
No, but as we see it now, Lea Cruz is just one silo. Are there other silos that you're going to look into? And do you believe that there will be more names apart from Lea Cruz, not in her network, that will be mentioned?
Well, I don't want to preempt the result of the investigation. I do not want to preempt or inform beforehand the persons or group we shall be investigating, but definitely we shall be investigating thoroughly, because we don't want to immediately make a conclusion regarding this issue without the proper evidence, or in the event that we shall be recommending the filing of the appropriate cases, definitely there will be evidence supporting our recommendation.
Congressman Elpidio Barsaga there, Cavite 4th District Representative. Thanks for taking our Zoom call. Take care.